Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A powerful earthquake has rocked the Caribbean and South America, as the first images of the devastation begin to emerge. A tremor has shaken eastern Venezuela through to Colombia and Trinidad, causing buildings to be evacuated in Caracas and Bogata. Cars have been flattened by collapsing walls, supermarket shelves have been completely wiped out, and gaping holes in the ground have begun to emerge in Trinidad. The quake has been placed at a 7.3 magnitude, with its epicenter being 13 miles southwest of Irapa, the U.S. Geological Survey says. A powerful earthquake has shaken eastern Venezuela, causing buildings to be evacuated in the capital of Caracas. A video showing the above damage was posted on a Trinidad Weather Center Twitter account with the caption, "Damage reported across Trinidad. Video taken at Digicel IMAX, Port of Sparan." This image shows the damage caused by the earthquake to a restaurant in Trinidad. This still shows the extent of the damage caused by the quake in a supermarket in Trinidad. The Pacific Tsunami Warning Center said a tsunami was possible within nearly 200 miles of the earthquake epicenter, which could hit Grenada, Trinidad and Tobago, although the warnings were lifted at 6:12 p.m. local time. Shocks from the earthquake were felt as far away as Colombia's capital Bogota, where authorities briefly closed the international airport to inspect for runway damage. While videos of Trinidad showed terrified customers leaving stores as products fell from shelves. In the Venezuelan capital of Caracas, office workers evacuated buildings and people fled homes in fear. The earthquake struck at 5:31 p.m. local time on Tuesday and was 76 miles deep. Residents and office workers in Caracas fled from their buildings and homes. At a shopping center, a woman caught in the panic of people rushing out of the building fell on an escalator and injured herself. In downtown Caracas, concrete from the unfinished Tower of David office building fell to the sidewalk, creating a potentially lethal haste. A block away, children wearing surgical masks stretched their neck toward the 620-foot building after having fled a nearby foundation for poor children suffering from cancer. "We felt something strong and they told everyone to run," said Marisela Lopez, who was at the foundation with her 7-year-old daughter when the quake struck. Venezuelan state media caught the confusion on camera as Diosdado Cabello, the head of the all-powerful Constitutional Assembly, was delivering a speech at a march. Footage captured at the scene shows people shouting, "Quake!" as Cabello and others looked side to side for cover. A similar-sized quake in the same area left dozens dead in 1997. Power outages were reported across nearby Trinidad, where people ran into the street and gasped as large glass panes at one supermarket shattered and falling concrete smashed several cars. The earthquake also was felt in Guyana, Barbados and Grenada. Interior Minister Nestor Reverol said that disaster relief teams had been activated, but so far there were no reports of fatalities. "We ask for the greatest patience and tranquility from the Venezuelan people," he said in a televised address. "These situations require prudence." The quake has been placed at a 7.3 magnitude, with its epicenter being 13 miles southwest of Irapa, the U.S. Geological Survey says. People stand on the street after hearing an earthquake alarm in Bogota, Colombia. People evacuate homes after an earthquake struck the northern coast of Venezuela, in Caracas. In the Venezuelan capital, office workers evacuated buildings and people fled homes. People gather in the street after an earthquake in Caracas, Venezuela, as they try to ring their family and friends. It was initially reported as a magnitude 6.7 and then 7.0, and was centered near the town of Carapano. A magnitude 7.3 quake is considered major and is capable of causing widespread, heavy damage. But seismologist Lucy Jones, a research associate with the California Institute of Technology, said the earthquake's considerable depth likely prevented a tragedy. "Shaking does die off at a distance," she said, adding that the depth of the quake means there are likely to be fewer aftershocks. Experts have long warned that Venezuela's cash-strapped government is ill-prepared to deal with a major natural disaster. Hospitals have scant supplies, many ambulances are grounded, and food and water are among goods that have disappeared in a country suffering from inflation estimated by the International Monetary Fund to reach 1,000,000% this year. John Bockett, a firefighter captain in Caracas, said there were no initial reports of injuries or major damage in the capital. Joan Lachman, a seismologist with the University of the West Indies Seismic Research Center, said it was the strongest earthquake felt in Trinidad since December 2016. She said there were 7 aftershocks within an hour of the quake, and that more were expected. The 7.3 quake was the largest to strike Venezuela since 1900, according to the U.S. Geological Survey. The earthquake is larger than the devastating tremor which rocked Haiti in 2010. Up to 300,000 people were killed when a 7.0 magnitude tremor rocked the Caribbean nation.